The answer that I'm looking for is the last one, but let's go through the other ones. Could we avoid a cache stampede by replicating the database? Yeah, in theory, but it's not a very good solution because, as we said, there's a cost to maintaining multiple machines, to running database queries. It's probably not the right approach, but it could work if you had enough databases to handle all of the reading you're doing. Only allow one web request at a time. Now, this could kind of sort of work, but it means, you know, when a request comes, you basically queue up all of the simultaneous requests that you're receiving so that only one person is hitting the database at a time. This could also work in theory, but then you've got to queue up these users somewhere and it slows down your site and it's generally probably going to be fairly painful. Only allow one database request at a time. This is similar to what I just mentioned. So we'd have to basically have all these requests, you know, basically block or wait on one request that's actually updating the cache or doing the query, that sort of thing. You could either do it in your web application, which would be tricky, or you can have some sort of lock in your database. Either way, it's not going to work out as well as you would like. And finally, you know, we just don't clear the cache. Instead, overwrite the cache with new data, so there's never this in-between time between when we write to the database and when we read from it again where the cache is empty. Make sure the cache is always full or warm. You know, basically, we refer to a cache hit as, you know, it's hit a hot cache or a warm cache. That means the data is already in there. And this is a very simple approach, and this is what we'll go with. Let's go ahead and implement this in AscuChan. Okay, so here we are in our AscuChan code. This is our line where we cleared the cache. We don't want to do this anymore. Instead, we want the cache to just go ahead and update when we submit a new piece of art. We're in our post function for creating art. So the way I'm going to do it here is I'm going to make this function toparts take a parameter called update. And what this parameter is going to signify is that if update is false, it's going to behave normally. But if update is true, we're going to update the cache. We're never going to read from the cache if update is true. So I'm going to use that parameter here. If not update, so basically if update is false and the key is in the cache, return the cache. Otherwise, run the query. So basically, if we set update to true, we'll always run the query. And then what we can do is we can go down. We don't need to change the reading. This basically says update false. We don't want to update the cache every time. We don't want to force that update. We want to go down here, and instead of calling cache clear, we want to say top arts true. This is going to rerun the query and update the cache. So that means the user who does the submitting triggers the rerunning of the front page query, and any users who are reading at the same time, who are loading the front page at the same time, won't ever hit the database. That means a page view will never hit the database. That's a very good quality to have. Let's go ahead and make sure things still work. So I reload the page. Everything still works. I look at the terminal. We see that there was a DB query that we just ran. Reload the page again. We see that there's no database query. Now let's go ahead and submit a new piece of art. OK, I'm going to submit a new piece of art. This is of the Linux Penguin Tux. Now, when I submit this, what's happening is we're inserting the new piece of art into the database and updating the cache. Now we can see that the redirect, the page reload worked, and our little tux was in fact submitted. And we go to our terminal, we look at what happened. We can see the start of our query. We've got this little error message from when we looked up the IP from that feature we had last week. We can see that in our console, we're printing DB query in the post request. These log lines aren't written until after the request is finished. So we're writing tux to the database. Then we're reading the database to get the 10 most recent items. And then we're redirecting the user. That's the 302. And then on our next front page request to get slash, there was no database write. So that means we're still doing the same number of database reads as we were doing before with the other solution, except the database read is triggered on submission and not on page load, which has a really nice property in that there's no database read for the front page load ever, unless the cache is completely empty.